There, the door everyone's forgotten about.
Wow, you're stronger than you look, Mrs. A.
Yeah, perhaps I am.
Enter the basement. Now we're getting somewhere. Pipes. Examine. Oh, yes. Water supply. I suppose this one could... Rent. Can't use them. Okay. Sure, why not? Take the extension cord. That'll come in handy. Cool, shoot. Let's open that. Oh, I'll need a crank for that. Can I use the spanner? No? Not the broom. I know what that's used for. Open. Alright. Can I use the spanner on the paint? Nope, it's not. That was worth a shot. Gladhaven Hotel? Never heard of it. What's the sign doing down here anyway? Let's take the dress. Maybe not, actually.
I think I've got an idea. I know how I could pay Brian back for all that he's done to me and the cats.
It's gonna be so great.
Brian. The guy from Flat 6, right?
Yes. Brian. That nasty piece of shit. He deserves to be punished, you know. And this wedding dress will be perfect for this. You ever heard the legend of the cat widow?
The cat widow? No, can't say I have.
Well, you're not from around here. But I'm sure Brian knows it. He grew up in this city, just like me.
So, what's it about?
It's an old story about a ghost cat who takes a human form to haunt her killer.
Wow, that's pretty crazy, Mrs. A. Do you really think we can pull it off?
Yes. Yes, of course. We just need to prepare. A good costume will do the job. This dress, we can alter it. We'll need some red paint, too.
Are you sure about that?
I promise this will work. And it will give us a chance to check his computer. If he's got one.
Okay. So what do we need?
Well, basically, we need three things.
A tin of red paint?
Red paint? There's a tin here. We could use that.
Usually in black dress.
A dress will make a great costume. We just need it in black. Also, it should look damaged. That's important. Cat Widow is a ghost, after all. I'll need some scissors for that. We need some kind of mask. I don't want him to recognize me, obviously.
It's gonna be so much fun. Alright, I need to open that first. Oh, first, as long as I'm here.
Well, well. Looks like Pauline is looking for a babysitter. This letter says she's supposed to interview an agency nanny later today.
Great. I could be a nanny.
It's certainly worth a try, but I should warn you. I don't want to have anything to do with that baby. You're gonna have to handle this on your own.
Sure, I understand. Leave it to me, Mrs. A.
Alert to Joe. It's from Dr. Frank Zellman. He appears to be Joe's shrink. Apparently, Joe failed to attend his weekly sessions recently. Well, well. Looks like Joe's just as messed up as I am. Or worse. Who knows? I should be the last to make judgments, really. I got the extension cord in my dress and letter to Molly. Alright, let's move. I still feel like these pipes should be useful. Yeah, okay. What am I supposed to use this for? I never cared much for DIY. But now as I find myself spying on my neighbors breaking into flats, it might actually come in handy. She got a point there. Alright. Moving right now to the next order of business. I believe the next order of business is... I'm going to use extension cord. Fly two.
Look, she left the door open.
Oh, right.
Do you want to check her flat? I'll stay here and keep watch.
Good idea. I'll be as quick as I can.
I completely forgot about that.
It's not her. I didn't find anything. No computers, no laptops, no telephone line. Okay, I'm not really surprised, are you?
At least we can now cross her off the list.
Can an old lady doesn't have a phone?
Let's go.
All right. In here again. There we go.
I'll try to catch that thing for you, all right?
Yay.
It's a statue of a cat. How nice.
So there's another wacko obsessed with cats in this house. Lovely.
Clearly. Now then, let's break it. There was a key inside the cat statue. What a strange hiding place. What happened to the good old doorman?
I see I caught this statue only so you could smash it to pieces. Thanks.
I don't remember asking you to catch anything.
I can't see what else is in here. I think you would to plug this in here, perhaps? Extension cord? No? Okay. Let's go upstairs to here. This is where things get very interesting.
Do you want to go in first?
Come on in. The place seems empty. Watch out, Mrs. A. There's a massive hole in the floor. Just step around it.
I'm not blind. Besides, I know it's there. We saw it from the floor below.
Let's have a look around. There's got to be a computer here somewhere.
I really don't like this place.
Yeah, it's rather creepy. Bingo! We found what we were looking for. This laptop could be it, you know. Maybe Joe is our guy after all. Oh, it's a disaster. The power lead is missing. It won't switch on.
Right. What a shame. Can we go now, please? I think I've seen enough. I don't need any more trouble.
No, it's okay. I've got an idea. It seems it's a similar model to mine. I'll just go back to the flat and bring my power lead.
I don't know. You sure this is gonna work?
I think so. At least we'll give it a shot. Just stay here and I'll be back in a second.
Just hurry up.
Yep. I'll just grab the power lead and run right back. It's just across the hall. I'll be back before you know it.
I will count to 100. If you're not back, I'm out of here.
I'll be back before you get to 75. Don't worry. Hey, I just remembered something that'll keep you busy. While I'm gone, think of a vegetable.
What? Why?
To keep your mind occupied. I bet I can guess which vegetable you are thinking of when I'm back.
So you're a mind reader now?
No. This is just a little experiment of mine.
Okay, whatever. Now go. I'm counting already. Why do I always end up in places like this?
Breaking your ears, I tried that myself, didn't cheer me up somehow. I don't want to take the doorknob as missing. It looks pretty old, they don't make them like this anymore.
That damn hole. Nearly forgot about it this time.
At no point, it stopped ringing now. And if it was ringing at all.
That damn hole. Nearly forgot about it this time. Right. I'm done waiting. I need to leave right now. Just one big step. Damn, the door handle just came off in my hand. How am I gonna get out of here now? Mitzi? Mitzi, are you there? Shit. Just one big step.
Oh, now I have no door handle. And it wasn't rocking before. The water from the bathroom completely flooded the bathroom floor, not my hair. Just wanted to leave as soon as possible. Okay, mannequin in the bath. This guy is nuts. No doubt about that. It's dirty like everything else in this place. Oh, power lead. Look who's home.
What the? I've got to get out of here.
You don't see that every day. You can't examine it, of course. Nah, that'd be a good one, anyway. Hello.
What? Jesus. No. You were not supposed to be here! Why did you have to ruin everything? What have you done, you stupid, evil bitch? Who are you?
I'm sorry, the door was open. I thought you moved out.
You took her away, didn't you? What has she ever done to you?
What? Look, sir, you are wrong. I just came here to find my cat. It's gone missing.
Yeah, I see. That stupid cat. I've been looking for it too. A little bastard took off with my key. I'm gonna rip him to pieces.
I don't want any trouble. Just let me go.
And I've got a gun. I can shoot you right there in your heart.
It's not worth it, Joe. I've done you no harm.
Of course, you haven't got a heart. Isn't that right?
I have no idea what you're talking about. Listen, I've got to go now, all right? I'll slowly walk out of here, and you'll never see me again. Calm down. I'll go now, and we'll forget all about this.
There's nowhere to go. It's all wrong. No matter what I do. Damn it! Get back here right now, and give me that blasted key!
Please, don't get angry. I don't have any keys. Just sit down and take a deep breath while I make my way out, all right?
Devil came through.
Come in, come in. There's no need to be afraid. I don't buy. Come in already. I might need your help with something.
There are mostly horror books on these shelves. One half of them are written by Stephen King. It's good with the pen.
You need my help. I thought you wanted to kill me.
Why would I want to kill you? You must be mistaken. Who do you think I am?
Sorry. I must have gotten the wrong idea.
It happens to me sometimes. I've been known to be a bit intimidating, I guess. But I'm not a violent person.
Okay. Good to know.
I mean, I will use violence if I'm pushed against the wall. Do you know what I mean?
All too well, Mr. Davis. all too well. Where are we?
I really can't remember the name of this town, but I'm pretty sure the hotel is called Quiet Haven.
This is a hotel?
I know, it's a joke. They shouldn't charge half the price for this dump if you ask me.
This is all just a dream, right?
It's funny that you would say that. I've already heard that somewhere today. But if this is a dream, I've been asleep for a very long time.
I'm sorry. I just want to leave.
Yes, I understand. I wouldn't stay here myself if it was my decision to make. I'm stuck here too. You see, my wife Ivy is in the room to the left. She's a little fragile at the moment. She said she was going to do her makeup, but it's been a week now, maybe longer. Every time I try to talk to her, she just gets angry, and she tells me she's not done yet. I've cooked her a meal, but she ignores me. She never likes what I cook.
But what's that got to do with me?
If you talk to her, I'll show you the way out, I promise. Just go in there and tell her she looks fine. She's always so careful about looking perfect.
Okay. I'll see what I can do. So, your wife's been in that room for a week?
Now that you bring this up, I think it might have been a month.
That's a very long time to stay in one place.
She wants to look great. I guess it takes time, but we really have to go now. I think there's a big storm coming. I feel it in my bones.
Goodbye, Joe.
There are bloody handprints all over. Which is obvious. And you can kind of see that. The metal cover is tightly placed. I can't move it by hand. I guess this is what I have a span for. This isn't a really good tool for the job, but it seems a bit too small. Well, damn. There's nothing special about the wardrobe. This is Joe's wife. Poor woman. This is horrible.
Hello? Misery. Is that what you said? Misery!
Okay. Search the bookcase. There's a book titled Misery here. Is that what she meant? It's a long shot, but I might as well try. It's forever. I suppose part of me expected it gone. But this will come in handy for sure. Right. There are two switches on both sides of the panel. I wonder what they do. This is gonna be, let's see. Thank you. I do not remember how this works at all. I didn't even think it at all. It's the handprints on the wardrobe. There are bloody handprints all over it. Two right handprints, the left and the right again. Give me a clue. Maybe? Right, right, left, right. That's what I did. Oh, there we go.
No. 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 No! This isn't Ivy! This isn't my wife! It's the monster. It followed me here. It always follows me. No matter what I do.
Look, I'm sorry.
You must kill it.
What? Why me?
You still got that power lead, haven't you? The one you stole from me?
How do you even know about it?
You must use it to kill her. To strangle her.
You're out of your mind.
Do it. Strangle the goddamn creature so it never follows me again, or I'll shoot you right here, right now!
Kill me if you want, but I won't do that.
You're with her? I should have guessed. I can't trust you. You're better off dead.
Are you all right, Mrs. A?
You look like you've seen a ghost.
Something strange happened. Maybe I am mad after all.
Don't be silly. I was gone for less than 1 minute.
Really? Somehow it felt longer than that.
Time drags when you've got nothing to do, I guess. I see you found the laptop cable. That's good news, because I don't think mine will be any good. Let's see what's on this hard drive, shall we? Well, that was a waste of time.
Never mind. At least now we're sure it's not him. Let's just go. I don't want to spend another minute in this place.
Hey, did you think of a vegetable?
What?
I'd asked you to think of a vegetable while I was gone. So? Did you?
Yeah. Sure.
Great. Now don't tell me. Was it... carrot?
Yes. A carrot. That's amazing. How did you know?
That's the secret. I can't tell you that, Mrs. A, or else it wouldn't be a magic trick anymore. Yay, it works every time.
Okay, okay, don't get too big-headed now.
Sure, but I am the greatest.
Look, I only said it was carrot to be nice. In fact, I thought about celery. I wasn't going to say, but you leave me no choice.
Yeah, right.
Yes. Now, let's go. Joe can come back any minute, and you don't want to meet him. He is not a nice guy.
Yep. Just another day in the life of Susan, Susan Ashworth, that's her name. Now they got a screwdriver, and a spanner, a wood dress, and a Mitzi. That's really all I came out of that with. Time for the babysitting job interview. Just looking at it is painful. What is it? Okay, nothing. Alright. Let me skip something there again.
Coming!
Right, step back. I'll handle this.
Oh, hello?
Hi. I've heard you're looking for a babysitter. Is that correct?
Well, yes, that's correct.
Look no further. My name is Mitzi Hunt. I'm currently a student, but I'm great with children. And I could really use a job. These school tuitions get pretty expensive these days.
Okay, maybe. But why is Mrs. Ashworth here? Hello, Mrs. Ashworth!
Hi, Pauline. How are you?
I'm great, thanks. I haven't seen you for ages. Are you here to apply for a job as well?
No, of course not. I...
Oh, I'm Mrs. Ashworth's lodger. She kindly offered me a room and we've been living together for the last couple of weeks. I mentioned to her I was looking for a job. My parents pay for the room and school fees, but I could do with some extra spending money. So, anyway, I'm starting this course on child psychology next semester, and I thought it would be useful to get some hands-on experience with little children. My mother always says you have to get your hands dirty to learn something properly. Not that you get dirty hands looking after babies. Just metaphorically speaking.
Well, it can get dirty. I hope you understand the job would involve changing nappies too.
Yes, of course. I don't have a problem with that.
Yes, well, you sure sound enthusiastic. Would you like to come in? Both of you?
It's okay. I'll wait.
I could really do with your support. You know how shy I get sometimes.
Yes. Well, you'll... Okay. You owe me.
We need to work together on this. I'll do the talking, I promise.
Fine. Just don't overdo it.
It's too late for that, Mrs. A. What a nice flat! I love the wallpaper. Very retro.
Thanks. I decorated myself just before Alyssa was born. Please follow me. We can talk in the living room.
I'll need you to drag her away.
How the hell am I supposed to do that?
I don't know. I'm sure you can think of something.
Why don't you think of something? I told you I don't do babies. I feel so uncomfortable here. I'd gladly blend with this cheesy wallpaper that you like so much and disappear.
I know. So do I. Do you think I know anything about babies? No, but I'm trying to fake it, and so far she's buying it. Look, I need you to stay cool and come up with something that'll make her leave the room. Got it?
But that's where the problem is. I can't think of anything.
Play it by ear, yeah?
Alright. You know, those are pictures of the baby. There are a couple of Pauline and her ex missing, his face missing on each one of them. Oh, what was the last one? She wants to get this guy out of her life so badly, why won't she just take these pictures down?
I should let you know from the start that looking after a toddler is not an easy task. They're just beginning to crawl, they're very curious, and sometimes they can cry for no apparent reason. And my Alyssa, well, she is a very noisy child. Do you have any previous experience with children?
Yes, I used to babysit my neighbor's kids.
Excellent. I know we all have to start somewhere, but it helps if you at least know the basics. I'd like to get back to work soon, you see. Just part-time for now. That's why I need someone to stay with her. I'm not going to find it easy to be apart from Alyssa. My career has always been important to me as well. They won't wait for me forever. If I don't do this now, they'll just replace me.
Where do you work?
I'm a hotel manager. It's a very competitive industry, but I've always loved it. I miss it a lot.
There just isn't enough support for working parents.
Tell me about it. If I don't get back to work in 2 weeks' time, they will cut my maternity pay in half. So I haven't really got a choice. It's either this or Alyssa and me will face the life in poverty.
Where's Alyssa's dad? Do you mind me asking?
I'd rather not talk about it. It's personal. As far as I'm concerned, Alyssa hasn't got a father.
I'm sorry, I shouldn't have asked.
No, it's all right, but I just don't like talking about it. I'm sure you'll understand.
I have a great connection with kids. I'm sure I can manage with Alyssa.
Okay, I don't doubt that. How about, would you like to hold Alyssa for a minute? We should probably see if she likes you first.
Yes, definitely. But I ought to wash my hands first.
Your hands?
My hands. I must have touched a million things on my way here. As much as I want to hold her, I just don't think it's safe, you know?
Really? What have you been touching?
Oh, you know, just ordinary things, this and that.
The germs are everywhere.
You look pretty clean. I'm sure it'll be okay.
Well, if you must know, I...
Ah, jeez. Yeah.
I volunteered at the hospital earlier today.
Oh, I'm impressed. You don't see many young people doing that these days. But you're right. As nice as that is of you, there's all sorts of bugs you can pick up in a hospital. It won't hurt to be extra careful. I'll show you to the bathroom. Would you mind answering the door for me?
Sure. No problem.
It's probably just my friend Kate. Just let her in, please. Is that okay? The bathroom's this way. Follow me.
Help.
Your turn, Mrs. A.
Seriously.
Do something. Anything.
Fine. Make sure you scrub those dirty hands really well. I need a bit of time.
Alright, let's do this door then. This would be great. Hello?
Hello?
Hello? Are you Kate?
I've been sent by the agency. My name is Rita Tickle. May I come in, please?
Agency? What agency?
The Happy Nanny Babysitters Agency, of course. We bring fun and professionalism into childminding at a discount price. May I come in, please?
Wait, just hang on a second.
I believe we have an appointment. It was confirmed by post. Didn't you get a letter?
Hang on, I said. I'm sorry, The position has already been taken.
Oh, right. Are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure. Thanks for your time. See ya.
Wait. There must have been some kind of mix-up.
No, there wasn't a mix-up. You're just too late. Bye.
I'd better call the office and find out what happened.
Yay! Is it BTV? You're the best friend, you know. Ooh, scissors. We should probably take those. Wouldn't want the baby grabbing them. What are we doing? Yeah. Isn't coming as the last time. Need order, I mean, let's hurry if they could be out any second now. Pauline's laptop. I don't know enough about computers to show it to Missy.
So, was it my friend at the door?
No, just some door-to-door salesman.
Well, I hope you told him to go to hell. I honestly don't know what these people are thinking.
Yeah, me neither.
I'm sure it's Kate this time. I'll let her in if you'll excuse me for a minute.
Wait! I think I've got something in my eye!
Right.
I can't touch my eye. I'll need some help to get it out.
You'll be fine. Just go back to the bathroom and use one of my cotton buds. Don't be such a baby, Mitzi.
I'm feeling really sick all of a sudden.
Do you think you're actually going to throw up?
Yes, definitely. Oh, yes.
Quickly, go back to the bathroom. I don't mean to be rude, but this is a very expensive carpet.
Will you come with me? Please? What if I faint? I'm scared. Everything's just spinning around.
Can Mrs. Ashworth go with you for a change?
It's okay. I'll answer the door and let your friend in, yeah?
Well... fine. I'll put Alyssa in her bed for a minute and I'll come with you. You must have got some bag in the hospital after all.
Yay! Okay. Oh, she's back.
It's you. Again.
Hello. Is this flat number 8? My name is Rita Tickle from the Happy Nanny Agency. May I come in, please?
Look, sweetheart, I'm sorry, I can't help you.
You are looking for a nanny, yeah?
No, not anymore.
I have 10 years experience and training in child discipline techniques and behavioural psychology. Also, I am known for good personal hygiene, strong work ethics, and I only take one break every 5 hours. Just to use the restroom.
Wow, that sounds really great, but I don't need your services.
You don't need a nanny.
No. I've decided to give my baby up for adoption.
You're an evil person. You'll go to hell for doing that to your baby.
Yeah, I'm evil. But you're thick.
Oh, priceless. Oh, right, well, I'm still here. Let me do one more thing real quick. Oh, right. You apparently can't do that just yet. What did it say? What did it say? Spirit suicide, oh right, yes. Wouldn't do that shit anymore, there must be a safer way. Like, turning it off first. There we go, and now I can cut it.
These scissors seem sharp enough. Let's create some diversion. I hope this is what Mitzi had in mind.
Oh, not that again.
What happened to the lights?
I'm
terrified of the dark. I can't move. Oh god, can't breathe.
Calm down, it's all right. Probably just that stupid meter. It must have run out of money again. It's not even that dark.
Please, you've got to do something about it. I think I'm going to faint.
Fine, just stay in my bedroom. There'll still be plenty of sunlight there at this time of the day. I'll go outside and put some money on the meter. It'll only take a minute.
Yay.
Right. Let's do it.
Is that you, Mrs. Ashworth? What happened?
No idea. Maybe it's a blackout, like in the old days.
It's probably just the meter. Let me see.
So it's not her either. What a waste of time. It's time to leave. This interview is over.
I don't get it. The cable's been cut. But why would anyone do that?
I think we're going to go now. This whole power cut gave me a terrible headache.
Is that you, Mitzi? But we haven't finished yet. Have you changed your mind about the job?
No, of course not. I'm just scared of darkness. And I still feel sick, you know. Perhaps we can continue some other time.
I've had it. I'm getting a new fuse box.
Was that you, Jesse?
Yeah. How are you doing, Pauline?
Well, we need the power back. Can you do something?
Yeah, I can easily fix that. There's an electrical store that's open till late. I'll get some stuff and I'll be back before you know it.
Bear in mind it's not just the fuse box, it's the cable this time.
I'll get a new cable too, don't worry. But in the meantime, go home, find some candles and chill, yeah?
Thanks, Jesse. That's awfully nice of you.
Well, it was great seeing you. But we're going to leave now.
Hello.
Who's that?
My name is Rita Tickle.
Rita who? What the hell is going on here? Do you know this woman, Mrs. Ashworth?
I've never seen her before in all my life. Now she'll think we are absolutely crazy.
I wouldn't worry too much. You're not exactly the most popular neighbor in the house, anyway.
Thanks.
What? You don't actually care what those idiots think, do you?
No. Of course not. It's just that Pauline seems all right. I'm not too proud of causing her all this trouble.
You'll get fixed soon. Look, Jesse's gone out. We can now get inside Flat 7 and see what he's been up to.
Okay. Yeah. That sounds good.
We can also cross Pauline off the list. I've searched through her internet history, and needless to say, there's nothing exciting there.
Alright. Should our door have not been in yet? Oh, right. I know what I need to do now. This is gonna be good. Oh, wait. First. Not actually done yet. So one more thing I need to do. I believe you are going to need to open this door for me.
Now that he's gone, we can get inside?
Yes, let's do that.
I'll close my eyes and you pick that lock, Mitzi.
Okay, but no peeking.
I'd never. You've really hurt my feelings now.
Yeah. Now close them.
I can't see anything anyway.
There. Job done.
Yeah.
Jesus, are these...
Relax, Mrs. A. They're just Halloween masks.
Oh, good. That's good. Because I swear, if I see another bloody head...
One second. That's what I thought. I thought so, it was a hockey mask. That's the one I want. None of these look illegal. These are just like plants. The speaker is massive. It's connected to Jesse's computer. Whatever he plays music or some, or whatever he plays music, the walls must be shaking. Sounds like me. Until I started using headphones, anyway. Alright. Socket. Zip. Alright. I know what I need to do. Portal. Do.
So, who's got windows over this side of the building?
Well, Joe Davis lives right below. But I'm not going there again. I want to make that clear. I guess we could also check one flat below Joe's. I just hope the cable's long enough.
Let's find out, shall we?
Yes, let's do that. It appears the cord isn't even low enough. Yay. Now I go back upstairs.
Be able to use that computer now. Could you give me 5 minutes, Mrs. A?
Sure. Why not? I'll keep an eye on the door.
Feel free.
It's not him either. God damn it!
Yes, the ground floor. It's gonna be the best. I can't wait. This is my favorite part of the game. I think it's just so great. Oh yes. Let's see if I can use a screwdriver or screwdriver now. Now I can use a screwdriver there. Can't use a wrench, can I? Where's Fenders? Cool. I'll need a crank. Oh! Can't use it here. There must be something else I'm missing. Flat 6 is the only one left. How do I get this open? Alright, I'm going to just hold the box through again. Okay, the walkthrough doesn't actually say anything about that, so maybe I don't need it. Let's use a screwdriver here. You could easily prize it open with the screwdriver. Then I can pick up the tin now, yay! Let's take the tin of paint then. Take it. Pack it. Hang back. Scissors. Come on. There we go. Scissors. Coach. Ah, yes. Just figure out how to make the dress black. I know I gotta use a clothes chute. How exactly? Let me look at this again. Oh, I see what I'm missing. I don't know why I didn't think of this. Oops. Check the map. Okay, flat 6. Can't be done by my hand, I'll need the right tool to remove it. And I believe I have one! Right here!
That'll teach you not to mess with the cat lady.
Yeah, you know, I have the crank. Alright, now I can actually get to that thing. Yay! Huzzah! Black is my color. I like it so much better now. Me too.
We need to make some adjustments. Now this is a dress worthy of the Cat Widow.
Why don't you admit it was too small for you?
Ha ha, bloody ha. Why don't you just shut up? Whoever wore this dress probably hadn't eaten in years. You'd struggle to get a skeleton into it. This is it. We've got all we need.
Great! Are you going to tell me about the Cat Widow now?
Yes. It's story time, Mitzi.
Oh, crap! No!
The legend says there was once a bad man who hated cats. He hated his neighbors, too, and his job. And when it rained, he'd curse and smash things. He hated his bald head and his weak, ugly body. He probably hated himself the most, although he would never admit it.
I think I see where this is going.
One day, out of pure hatred for the whole world and everything that lives, he captured a family of cats and drowned them all in the river. That day, the sun turned black and all the birds went silent as the six kittens struggled for life. But trapped in a strong canvas bag, they never had a chance. They all died that day. All but one. The mother cat, in a desperate fight to set herself free, by pure luck, clawed her way out of the bag and swam to the shore. She lost everything that day. Her beautiful children and her proud husband. Her heart crashed into pieces as she watched their limp, dead bodies stolen by the current. Running after them, she followed them for days, for as long as she could. Then, eventually, she lost sight of them. She stayed on the bank of the river for a while. The world stopped turning for her, her eyes empty and blind. And then, one day, she slowly slid down the bank and into the cold, dark water. She gave in to it. She let the river take her away too, cover her mouth, her ears, her eyes. But as the water filled her lungs and she started slipping into darkness, there was another strange feeling that burst in her mind like a ball of flames. Anger, rage even, her last craving, before she drowned, was for revenge, for blood. And so she returned, reborn and changed, a cat widow, veiled in black, mistress of the cats, her body of a young woman, but her eyes of a cat, and her face, white, rotten, face of a corpse. Those who saw it rarely lived to tell the tale. She would get her revenge on all cat killers and cat torturers. But there was someone she had to see first. Someone special. Someone she really hated the most. As the evening came, it was strangely quiet in the man's flat. As he lived alone, he usually liked to fill the silence with the sound of radio or TV shows. But that night, he switched them all off, feeling anxious and tired after work. He tried to sleep, but couldn't. And for once, there wasn't anyone there he could blame for it. As he stared through the window, he kept thinking about how much he hated that view. He liked it once, a long time ago, when his wife was still there and they were happy together. Suddenly, he heard knocking on the door. Some part of him was glad, because that meant he could take it out on whoever decided to bother him. there was nobody there. He almost felt disappointed. But before he turned to walk away, he suddenly noticed something down the hall. On a nearby wall, there was a giant shadow of a cat. He stopped again. He couldn't believe his eyes. Someone wrote "Cat Killer" on his door.
That's what the pain was for.
He had a passion for trains. Although he hated being a train driver, he had always enjoyed watching them move. But now, his train model was moving all on its own. He was absolutely certain he'd left it switched off. And yet, there it was, running at crazy speed, remote control missing. Something was seriously wrong, and that something had entered his home now too. He hoped he was just imagining things, tired as he was, but there was another surprise waiting for him in his bedroom.
Oh yes.
A giant, blood-soaked zombie cat sat on his bed.
Now that's really stupid.
Fair enough. That didn't really happen. Everyone knows there's no such thing as giant zombie cats, right? What really happened was this. "Cat Widow is here," was written all over the wall. As in a dream, he went to the kitchen to get a drink. There was no water. He knew there were valves in the basement that turned it off, but no one's been down there for years. He felt sick. None of this made any sense. And yet, deep down, he knew what he did to the cats was wrong. There was a part of him that almost wanted to be punished. The part he tried so hard to hide. He thought he'd heard something in the corridor. Was there someone there with him? His head was spinning. He felt ambushed, trapped, like an animal. He had to get out of there. Getting really scared now, he decided to call the police. His phone was of no use. The SIM card had been removed, and that wasn't even the worst part. There was a photo of a black cat set as screensaver. He remembered this cat. He'd watched that strange pest control man put it in a cage and into his van. He'd looked at it through the window for a while, then pulled the curtains and went to bed. He stopped, paralyzed. He'd heard something right in front of him. A whisper. More like a purr. She was there, in the dark corner of his living room, waiting. Black veil covering that pale, dead face. And yet, he could almost feel Cat Widow's eyes piercing through him. She came closer, like a ghost, and swiftly removed the veil. She came back for him, to take him to the river, to make him pay for what he'd done. As he looked into her eyes, he could feel the world spinning around him, his knees go weak, his pants suddenly wet around his crotch. As much as he hated life, he didn't want to die either. Inside, he was just a big, stinking coward. And then he fainted. Did you see his face? I knew he'd fall for this.
Yeah, we scared the living shit out of him. Now that's teamwork. Are you sure he won't know it was you, though?
Oh, he probably will, once he's had time to think about what happened. But he's too proud to ever admit he's been beaten by a woman. I know him just about enough to know that.
Let's hope so. I don't want you to get in trouble because of me.
No. That was something I had to do for myself. And I feel much better for it.
The only problem now is that we still haven't found Eye of Adam. Because it definitely isn't Brian. I've searched through his laptop and all I found was a load of porn.
Let's cross him off the list.
Well, that means we've checked everyone. We've hit a brick wall. Perhaps I was wrong. Maybe he doesn't live here at all.
I think we need to sleep on it. And we might get some more ideas in the morning. Shall we head back home?
Yeah, I do feel tired. You're right, we need some sleep. I really wish there was an elevator in this building. What's that? A note? What does it say, Mrs. A?
You will not believe it. Meet me at midnight, both of you. I will wait. Flat 5. Door will be open. Do not fear. Eye of Adam.
That's the old guy. Can't be. It can't be him.
I guess we'll find out. At midnight. We've got a few hours until then. Let's get some coffee.
Sounds like a great plan. I just think we're gonna need a drink too.
It's just you and me, my love. No one will find us here. Stop worrying, Ivy. It will be all right. I will always love you. You know that. I'm gonna make you all better.
Okay, before we do this, Joe Wendell, I'm going to go ahead and bring up Nate's lemonade. I'll also explain that little scene that you just saw with the with Joe and his wife Ivy. Momentarily. Inclusion of this whole game and his little backstory and the scene that just happened is a reference to a previous game from Harvester Games called Downfall, which was recently remade in the Renaissance. I played the original, but it's pretty weird.
Just look at this door. Crazy son of a bitch. That's not gonna stop us. I think there's someone in the kitchen. Are you Adam?
Me? No, of course not. I don't have anything to do with all this foolishness. Never have. It's my son. I've told him time and time again, but he never listens. I've done my best to protect that boy, you know. I'm all he's got left in the world since his mama died, but it just wasn't enough.
Where is he then? Where's Eye of Adam?
He's in his room. Where else would he be? He's always in his room, staring at that screen for as long as he can. Look, I've made up my mind about this. I want to help you. This mess he's in, it's gone too far. I can't be part of this.
What are you talking about?
You don't understand. He's watching us. right now. He can see us on his camera. He's very clever with this stuff. I never got my head around it. Just as much as I needed to, I guess. But not a lot.
Give us the key to his room. I want to talk to him.
Look, it's a trap. He knows why you're here, and he will kill you. Both of you. But he will not kill me. He won't dare. All these years, I've looked after him well. He owes me everything. It breaks my heart to do this now. What choice do I have? He left me this. I was supposed to keep it for myself, but I want you to take it. He won't dare to kill his own father. I won't let two innocent lives be lost because of him.
What is it?
Just take the damn thing. There's not much time. Didn't you hear me? He's watching.
What is it, Mrs. A?
It's a shoebox.
Take it away. Get rid of it. He must see that I don't have it anymore.
Shall we open it?
Oh, God. Mitzi, we have to get out of here. Quickly. It's a gas mask. He's going to poison us.
Too late!
Shit. Oh, shit. Shit. Shit.
No! Stop that, Adam! You're going to kill your father!
We'll never make it to the door. That room is filling up with gas too quickly. Put the mask on, Mrs. A.
What about you? No. No, I can't!
You've got to. This is your only chance.
No. I can't let you die. Not like this.
It's my fault that you're here. I'm dying anyway. And you've got to live, Mrs. A. You'll live and you'll be happy again. You've been a great friend, Mrs. A.
No. You've got a date, and I'll make sure you turn up for it. There is no time to argue. I'll be fine. Now. Do it!
Welcome home, darling. I've been waiting for you. What took you so long?
Say what you've got to say and let's finish this. I'm tired of you. Tired of all this madness. I just need to get back.
Very well. I'm not planning to keep you long. Let's go inside. I have one last job for you. There are still 2 candles left, Susan. You know how this works. A soul for a soul.
And that's it. I blow out the last candle, and I'll never have to see you again.
Only if you blow out the right one, I'll never bother you again. Isn't that what you want? But if you choose wrong, it will be your life extinguished forever. Just take a deep breath and do it.
But how should I know which one's right?
That's the thing, Susan. You can't know that. In life, you can't always know the consequences before you make a decision. Haven't you learned that yet?
That's not fair.
Nothing is fair. You opened your heart talking to that doctor, and he butchered you like an animal. Then, those disgusting cannibals, they chop you up and cook you for dinner if you'd let them. And what about the man with the flowers? All that he wanted was to hear you play before he split your skull open. The way your husband treated you, the way your neighbors laughed at you for years, just for being different. You did not deserve all that, and yet it happened. Am I forgetting something? Oh, yes, of course. Most of all, was it fair that...
Shut up! Just shut up, you ugly bitch! Now I know who you really are. All those feelings I had in me for years. That bitter guilt and self-pity. That hatred for myself and everyone else. You are that miserable illness that's consumed my heart all these years. You, always there, always. Every day I looked at you in the mirror, like a dark cloud I couldn't see through. I let you take control of my life. I believed it was right to feel like this. But not any longer. This ends here.
Then blow out the candle.
No, I won't. I'm done playing your stupid little games. You won't tell me what to do anymore. I am stronger than you. I can close my eyes and you'll be gone.
Blow out the candle.
It's time to say goodbye, sister. I'm not gonna miss you.
You will never leave this place without me. You need me. We are one.
No. Tomato. You were thinking about a tomato, right?
Tomato is a fruit, silly.
Who cares? I like tomatoes.
So do I. But I hate to disappoint you, but I was really thinking of onions.
Why onions?
They're the saddest of the vegetables, of course. They make people cry. What happened, Mrs. A? I saw you die. And yet, you're here. Alive, like... if nothing's ever happened.
Well, let's put it this way. Everyone knows cats have 9 lives. So do cat ladies, apparently. But this time, I feel there won't be second chances. I'm down to 1 last life now. I can't afford to waste it.
You are such a nutter, Mrs. A. You are absolutely fucking bonkers. But I'm so happy to see you. Never, ever do that to me again, all right?
I can happily promise you that, Mitzi.
This is it. his room is through that door. It's time to face the Eye of Adam.
What are we waiting for? Let's do it.
You're the Eye of Adam? A pathetic, wheelchair-bound invalid? Is this a joke? Do you know who I am? Do you know what you've done to me? You fucking murderer! Tonight it's your turn to die. I'm gonna paint this room with your brains and I'm gonna watch and smile. I swear to God I'll do it. Well, nothing to say? Nothing at all? Aren't you going to beg for your sad little life? Say something! Anything!
Mitzi, where did you get that gun from?
It doesn't matter. Please, Mrs. A. This is something I have to do. You are free to leave if you want. You don't have to be a part of it. Just try to understand. Beg for forgiveness, you scum! What the fuck is wrong with you? You don't believe I'm gonna shoot you, do you? Oh, I've dreamt of this moment for so long.
Look at this man, Mitzi. He hasn't twitched a muscle since we entered the room. I think he's paralyzed.
That's impossible. He's lying to us. He's faking it. Do something. Talk for God's sake. I need you to answer me. I need to know.
He won't answer you. He can't talk.
Then how did he post all that stuff online? How did he do it?
I think I know how. See that little device on his left eye? I've heard about these. It's a controller. It seems the only part of his body he can move is his eyeball. Controller connected to the computer tracks its movement, allowing him to...
What? That's ridiculous! How do you even know such things?
I'm a nurse? I've seen these before. Well, I've seen eye-controlled wheelchairs, but there's no reason why it wouldn't work with a computer.
Jesus. That would explain the whole Eye of Adam thing. He really is just the eye. But no, that doesn't change anything. He must die. He deserves nothing more. What? You arrogant shit! I will fucking do it! Just tell me one thing. One thing. Why? Why did you make Jack kill himself? Fine. It'll be a pleasure. Ready to die, scumbag?
Look at these oxygen tanks. I don't think it's a good idea.
What? Why not? I'm the one holding a gun here. and I will blow this bastard's brain out as soon as he looks at me. You hear me? Look at me! I want you to see what you've done! The pain you've caused me!
Mitzi, that's not what I meant. Just put the gun down for a second.
No! No! I can't do that, Mrs. A. I'm sorry. This is something I have to do. I have to!
Can't you hear that hissing sound? These cylinders are clearly leaking gas.
Please, stay out of it!
You'll make a whole room blow up.
I don't care. Just leave me alone.
You lied to me. You never said you wanted to kill him.
Now, wasn't that quite obvious? What did you think I wanted to do? Have a coffee with him? Chat about the weather or politics? For God's sake, I'm here because this son of a bitch needs to die. If I don't kill him now, he'll just carry on and more innocent people will lose their lives. Do you really want that? Because I don't.
Think about it for a second. Would Jack really want this?
This bastard messed with Jack's head. He tricked him. That's what he does. He fucking tricked him.
But would Jack really want you to become a murderer?
No. He wouldn't. He wasn't violent at all. He was the kindest, sweetest guy I ever knew.
Exactly. Now, put that gun down already.
But what about me? No, I'll do it. I know Jack will forgive me.
This isn't the way to do it. Just turn these computers off instead.
No! He doesn't deserve to live after what he's done.
And who are you to serve justice like this? Do you really want to kill an unarmed, paralyzed man?
Why are you doing this, Mrs. A? I thought you were my friend.
That's exactly why I'm doing this. Even if we survive the explosion, how will you be able to live with yourself?
I won't have very long to live with it. I'll manage just fine.
Without his father, he's harmless. He was the one who supplied him with all this technology. He fulfilled his every single wish. I know this guy's rotten bad. There's no excuse for what he did. But he will be punished for it. Trust me. They'll put him in some stinking nursing home. He'll live his life like a vegetable, stuck to bed. He'll have time to think about what he's done. And he'll never see a computer screen again. Isn't that enough?
He said, do it! He wants to die, and I want to kill him.
He wants us all to die. Can't you see that? Isn't that what he's been preaching? A joint suicide. That's why he wants you to shoot him. So we can all get blown to pieces.
His final act. The work of his life. Are you really going to give him that satisfaction? Remember what you said about feeding the troll? That's exactly what you're going to do if you kill him now.
No. Maybe you're right. You should leave, Mrs. A. I've never wanted you to get hurt. But I'm not going away without this fucker dead. Even if that means I die too.
Mitzi, have you lost your mind? You're going to sacrifice your life for this scum? He's a parasite! A worthless, evil piece of shit!
It's not like I've got anyone to live for, is it?
What? What about your mother? Your family?
She's dead! Yeah, I lied. I always lie. I grew up in an orphanage. My family never wanted to know me. The only person that cared about And he's dead. Yeah. Happy now? So get the fuck out of here and let me do what I got to do.
I care about you. Do it for me. Come on, mate. It's been a long day. Let's go home. We've won.
Have we really?
Trust me. I know we have.
How?
I'm the cat lady. From now on, I win every single day. It's me, again, talking about my ordinary little life, as usual. I'm still surprised anyone would want to read this at all. The ramblings of a cat lady. I met some people. We go out sometimes, and I'm not alone anymore. It turned out there were others who felt like I did. I talked to them, tried to help. And now, I'm writing this blog. I must confess, yesterday was bad. It was one of those days when you feel like you're back in the past, and all the good stuff that happened was just a dream. But I woke up today, feeling better. Maybe I can never get rid of it. This invisible illness. Maybe it will always be living somewhere deep inside me, asleep, waiting. And when it'll hit me, it'll hit me hard. But if there's one thing Mitzi taught me, it's that you have to pick yourself up and carry on. It doesn't matter that life isn't fair. It doesn't matter that you make mistakes. You fall and rise again. And speaking of Mitzi, well, I don't know what happened. I guess I never will. But against all odds, she just got better. Maybe it's because of that last candle, or some other things I did that year. I don't really care. She's still here. That's all that matters to me. Every time I visit my daughter's grave, she comes too. We don't have to talk. It's just nice to have somebody there with me. World's full of liars, traitors, cowards. But every now and then, you meet someone like Mitzi, who will just smile at it all. Now, I've forgiven the world and myself too. I teach myself to smile again. One day I'll get there. I know I will. Even if it takes me not 9, but 900 lives.
You open up your heart to all the things you feel before. You're keeping healing.
team just kind of shut itself down, I guess. My phone is in the middle of typing. Give me a second. I'll get back to my channel in a second. I was about to say something important, and I was working on it anyway. So, as long as I have the game down, I guess I'll say what I was typing anyway. Okay, as I was saying, yeah. In Joe's room, I would have strangled Missy if I had actually done that. Yeah, there are definitely multiple endings. This is a true ending. Also, the other thing was, as that ending just suggested, not blowing out the last candle. Because that last candle was Missy's life. If I had blown out that last candle, she would have died. And that's still like... That's pretty much the normal ending, because she was a cancer victim. But there is a true ending where you can save her, so I went and did that. It's pretty awesome. Because it's the all those things and the candle. At a belief saver. Which is pretty sweet. Yeah. I'm not surprised you're smart. So, tend to figure things out like that. As long as I'm still here, let me open the game again, just so I can... while I talk here. That was again, one of my favorite games, by far, for obvious reasons. Such a good game. And I'm glad I got to show it to you, Lynn. Trailer automatically plays, apparently. The trailer is really great, though. I love this trailer. Mm-hmm. call this, calling good on this and with the game. This time intentionally, even. And thanks for watching, anyone and everyone who possibly did.